Gentlemen, don't be bashful.
Well, I'll start off by addressing litter control, because this has been a thorn in my side since I became mayor. I know in the city of Valdosta, and I know outside the city limits, and in some of the other communities, we all have a real problem. I know all of you have seen people just riding down the road and throw a McDonald's bag out, or throw a dirty diaper out the window, or something like that. And we have this kind of stuff, and we do everything we can to keep it clean, but it's a full-time job, and you can't, you know, it's hard to put enough people out there to keep every piece of paper picked up there. So somehow or other, we've got to get the attention of the residents of the different communities, and you know, I heard the situation this morning, we were talking about blowing, you know, we've sent out a letter recently about blowing your leaves out in the street, blowing your pine straw out in the street, and thinking that the city or the county or the different municipalities are supposed to pick it up, and people, you know, are responsible for their own right of way. And so it's a real problem, and I look forward to us addressing that and letting everybody know that we are armed in our beliefs that they have to help us. And you know, I'd be glad to do my part in that any way I can.
What if we could show a value to that collectively, everybody could get together, and I know it's hard to get an exact number, but if we could, through education, we can show the value of the cost of that, is a better word. It's taxpayer money to clean this stuff up, you know, and I think it's that number would probably be taxed if we could show evidence of that. And maybe a good public service announcement to start with that, and here's the cost of the taxpayer of our community for doing that.
I agree. I think that that's one thing that certainly we need to know, and then of course our staff can pull those numbers together for us, and just so that all the local governments will be able to see what we're actually spending on litter control at this point. You know, I like to say litter control, but really we've got a situation in the community where our litter is out of control. Again, this is an extremely important item, so I think that if we can get that cost, as far as saying, as you say, get that cost number, and then see certainly if we can do some things. Maybe I'll add one to it, and of course it goes right along with getting the attention of the citizen. But I think community education is going to be a big part of what's going to have to be done here from the standpoint of the control as well.
Well, as the city of Lane Park, we are the gateway city into Lowndes County. And we're constantly cleaning up Highway 41. There's a constant flow of litter. And I think that we need a take pride initiative, possibly put through education, get the word out. How do you do that? Perhaps more meetings like this, invite the public in, let them know that unified Lowndes County will bring in more business and more people into the community, and will give people a sense of pride.
Yeah, I agree. Ms. Tibbet?
Well, I'll agree with him with that. Now, we've got to get the community, the citizens more involved. We need to find a particular way to get them involved. You know, to get people involved, we have to give certain things like incentives or something like that. One thing that I just a little thought when I was talking about with some things with some people, say this, if you see a little bird, little bug or somebody doing something like that, report it. If you report it, you know, if you get them $2 off your water bill, about something like that to get them incentive. We have to get them as citizens involved. We get them involved more, then they won't litter because somebody might see them doing it, something like that. But that's my thing. If whatever we can do, how can we do to get the citizens involved to help keep the area clean? That's a big, that's a lot. Because that's where it's coming from, a lot of the citizens, a lot of people, just, you know, the neighbors going and throwing things out. You see people throwing things out of the car. You can take your tag on, report it. That's one of the best ways I think we've got to find our community. We've got to work out sales, citizens themselves that help each other to keep the city clean.
Thank you, ma'am. I also would feel like that it would be extremely important, certainly to the citizens of the community, as well as from the enforcement standpoint, that we all take a look at whether we have a litter ordinance in place, what the structure of that litter ordinance is, and can we develop some consistency amongst that, with that litter ordinance amongst the local communities? I think that's extremely important. If you're going to have something that you're going to be able to enforce in a community, again, we're looking at something as a whole that's going to affect this community. I think it's extremely important that you do have some consistency and some continuity between the ordinances so that it does look the same if you're in Lake Park or in Valdosta or Hayhigh, or if you're just in the unincorporated areas of Lowndes County. Those efforts to keep your community clean is consistent throughout, so I think that we would need to consider those as well. Anything else we need to add to that?
Well, I would like to just mention, which I agree with everything that's been put up there so far, one thing we need to do is start in our own backyard first, which most of us do have garbage providers. And just watching our garbage providers picking up the garbage and everything, I see a lot of problems right there. When they're distributing garbage up and down the road, they don't care how much is left after they dump the cans. And if the wind catches in and blows in, I mean, it's just scattered all over. I would suggest let's start our own backyard before we start taking anything else for the people.
Okay. Good point.
Sir, I said quarterly yard of the month in sections of District 1. Now, that's what got District 1's attention, saying it was going to come out and do quarterly yard of the month. This section of District 1 is with other sections. Because District 1 has lost their pride. And I, what everyone said, you got to get the people back to love where they live at. And so far in District 1, we don't have any pride this time. So we got to get something to build our momentum back up, that we care about where we live at. In the 70s, we cared where we live at. In the 2000s, now, we don't care where we live at. It doesn't matter where you move at, you got to, whether you rent or own it, you got to clean up where you at. And it comes back to taking pride in where you live in, that education, caring. I have not always been a homeowner. Even when I was a renter, I cleaned up where I was. It comes back to how we're raising our children and how we're being taught everywhere. It starts at home, like you said. It starts in our own back door.
Let me ask this then. We've got several items here that, in an effort to move forward, do we not think that, or could we agree that litter control is primary function for public works in each one of our local governments? Any objection to that? Then what I would like to propose at that point is that each one of our public works directors, whomever might have that responsibility in the collective cities, if we could get those folks together and take these issues and then begin to come up with some kind of plan, that again, that they would be able to agree on, that would be consistent throughout our community, that we could address litter control, and then come back at our next meeting with a plan of attack, you might say. Is that fair enough? We'll address it that way.
Sure.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so we are in the that we have the education part, because we have those children home and have to take the education system and so we have a lot to do with it. Continue to work with us and talk about their education.
And I agree, and again, that goes back, into the education, the litter portion of it. I think bottom line is litter, to me, is probably one of the most important things that we need to address as a community. But I think, or I believe, that litter plays a huge part of just economic development from that standpoint. You've got folks coming into our community looking at our community, whether it be to locate an industry here or whether it just be to retire and come into this community and maybe start a small business. If this community is not neat, clean, manicured, and well taken care of like it should be, to where, you know, those folks look at it, they should know that this community has a sense of pride and that we care about our surroundings, care about our community enough that we're going to make the effort to clean it up and make it neat. And so that's going to make them, hopefully would help them make a decision as far as to locate businesses and industry in our community. So I think that, again, that is extremely important. Okay? Anything else?